Yes, I would like to sign up for that yoga membership. My email address is gocanucksgo1997@hotmail.com. Maybe it's not the Canucks. Maybe it's lucasistheman78@hotmail.com. Maybe your email address is tied to your internet company and you hate them and you want to leave. I'm going to show you how to change your email address so that you can put these behind you. So there are five main steps to go through. The first one is to choose a new email address that you are happy with. The second step is to forward the old email address to the new one with automatic email forwarding. The third step is to set up an autoresponder so that when people send an email to the old address, they get a vacation auto reply thing that says that your address has changed. The fourth step is figure out what to do with the actual emails that are in that account. You can download them, keep them somehow. You can put them into another server. And the fifth step is to just leave it like that for a year or two or five, however long you want, so that everybody in your life and business, they learn your new address. So I'm going to go through those in a little more detail now, but those are the main steps. Choosing your new email address is a branding question. Basically, it's what email address do you want to be saying over and over again for the rest of your life? If you want to do free ones, I really like Gmail. I like iCloud. With iCloud, it uses your storage that you pay for. So if you're already paying for storage for photo syncing and file syncing, stuff like that, then your iCloud email address, your name at iCloud.com, it uses that iCloud storage. It's harder to get a good email address with those because all of the good ones are taken. So if you wanted to just have your first name, last name at gmail.com or at iCloud.com, it's very unlikely unless you have a really unique name. So those are the free-ish options. I love domain names where you just register a yearly name. Like I could get lucasroberts.com, for example. And then that comes with a cost. It's about $20 a year. And I can set up lucas@lucasroberts.com as my email address, or theboss@lucasroberts.com as my email address. Don't know that I would want to say that for 40 years or 50 years, but that's beside the point. So with that, you're paying yearly for the name itself, and you also need to pay monthly for email hosting. It's usually $6 a month or $8 a month, that kind of thing. Google Workspace has email hosting. It's, I think, around $8 Canadian per month, $6 US per month. iCloud gives you the option of using a domain name now, so you can do that as well. But those ones cost money, but they look better. So those are some things to think about when you're trying to decide what you want your new email address to be. Setting up email forwarding, you actually need to go to the webmail, so using Safari or Chrome or Firefox, and sign in and go to the settings, go to the options for that email account. So it could be AOL or Hotmail or Yahoo, it could be AT&T or Verizon, wherever you are, whatever internet company you have, you need to figure out how to go to their webmail and then sign in, so you need to figure out your password. But then you're looking for options. Here in Shaw is a Vancouver internet company. In Shaw webmail, I just go to preferences here. Sometimes you'll see your name in the top right. You can click this and you'll see settings or options in the top right. But the point is, go to webmail, sign in, and then go to preferences or go to settings. Generally under the mail section here, you'll see forwarding. Sometimes it'll be a section called forwarding. All you need to do is just say forward a copy to and then type the new email address. And then just hit save. Maybe it's done. You know, maybe you need to scroll down to the bottom and say save down there. I always check this box to remove local copy of message. So what that means is the message forwards, it goes straight through to my new address and it won't fill up, it won't slowly fill up the Shaw mailbox with the messages, because it essentially does a straight forward and deletes them straight out of SHA. So that is a cleaner way of doing it. It prevents the SHA mailbox from getting full. And then I just hit save. And now every email address that comes to my SHA address, it automatically shows up in this new email account. Setting up an autoresponder is quite similar. You have to go to the webmail, have to sign in, go to options, preferences, settings, whatever. And you will see out of office or vacation auto response, that kind of thing. And you just turn it on. You basically say, you know, from today and forever. And you would just say something like, hi there, I received your email, but it's been forwarded to my new address. Here's my new address, blah. And then you say, yes, I want to send it during the following time period, turn it on for today, and then set it to end on never, or 10 years from now, 20 years from now, whatever. So basically what that means is every time somebody sends you an email, it forwards to you, so you get it, but it will also give them an auto reply that says, hey, FYI, my email address has changed. Here's the new address. The next step is figuring out what to do with the email history, the emails that are in your old email account. Two main options, download them to your computer and keep them just on your Mac. That means that they're only on this computer, your phone won't have access to them, they're not in a cloud. The other option is to move them into a cloud, move them into another email account. In this video, I'm only going to talk about putting them down on the computer, just because moving messages into a server, there are a bunch of possible issues with that. It's very dependent on how much email, how many folders, how fast is your internet upload, what program are you using, stuff like that. Don't want to get into that in this video. So I'm just going to show you how to grab them from the old email account and save them on your computer so you have them. To get the messages from your email account into your Mac, just go into Apple Mail, assuming that your email account is set up here, and then go to the Mailbox menu and say New Mailbox. And then under Location, choose the On My Mac section down here. So that this means it's only on this computer. And normally what I would do is I would say, you know, SHA Inbox or Hotmail inbox, and then say okay, and then I would make a new folder. Another way of doing it is you can hover your mouse over the On My Mac section so that you see the little plus button here. Hit the little plus button, and then I would say Hotmail sent folder. So that just handles inbox and sent. If you have other folders as well, then that's you can add those afterwards. But just doing inbox first, you go edit and select all. So now that has highlighted all of the emails in this inbox. And then I normally do it carefully. I'll do the message menu here, copy to, and then go down to the Hotmail inbox thing. And I triple check. I say, yes, it's copying down to the Hotmail inbox. And so when you click that, it starts copying. It'll say down in the bottom left, you'll get some progress here. You need to give it a bit of time in order for it to do that, especially if it's a lot of email, it can take a while. So give it a bit of time to finish that transfer. You need to just repeat that same process for the sent folder. So you go to the sent, then you go select all, and you copy those as well. And the last step is just leave it like this for really as long as you want, as long as you feel comfortable with, because it takes time for your friends, your family, business contacts, for everybody to find out that you have a new email address. You can message people, you can do like a bulk, you know, email, that kind of thing, maybe a few people at a time using the BCC, blind carbon copy. But you want to allow a year or 2 years or something like that, just to make sure that people who have that email address, they find out that your email address has changed. Some things that we can help you with in a consult, if you want to book with me or someone from my team, we can just go through this with you so that you don't need to think about it. We can help you pick and set up a new email address that you feel good about. We can help you with a domain name and Google Workspace setup. That's the one that's 20 bucks a year and $7-$8 a month. We can help you with setting up your iCloud email and tying it to a domain name, Office 365, Microsoft Exchange, things like that. We can help you with big jobs, like if you have 10 or 15 email accounts and you want to simplify down to 2 or 3. If you have trouble getting the emails down into your Mac, downloading mail into your Mac, we can help you with that. If you want to move your emails from one server to another, so that's the thing I talked about, moving the emails into another email account, into a cloud, so that you have access to those emails from all your devices, we can help with that. If you want to change your Apple ID, when you have an old email address, you might have signed up for a bunch of things with that old email address. We can help you quickly go through all those different companies and all those different websites and update your email address with them. Or really, whatever else is bugging you about your email, you can just head to macinhome.com/booking and book a consult. Boom! Mac epiphany. If you found this helpful and you want some private Mac coaching with me or someone from my team, just head to macinhome.com/booking. We work with people all over the world. We'll help you with whatever is on your Mac problems list, and you will never feel judged or shamed for whatever mess you're in. We're doing it. We got this. One more time.